Oh, I think they're giving people like a special ticket envelope or something here. I already have a boarding pass, but I should go check in again so I can get an envelope. Let's go over here and get a nice view of the queen. Oh my gosh, she's right there. I can't miss her.
Thank you so much. Yeah, that's all right. Appreciate it.
So it is aircraft number 8418, which I think is N118UA tail number. So all but two of the United 747s have been flown away to the desert. There's an airport at Victorville, California, which I think is in San Bernardino County, where there's a facility that retired planes are taken for disassembly and recycling. There's a helicopter landing over there. Unfortunately, the plane is kind of at the end of the concourse here, so there's not really a perfect side view of it anywhere. Except, well, no, not even from here. No, still the nose, but that's a great straight-on view. Yeah, no view at all of the right side. Okay, well, let's go back to the party. I'm gonna go get checked in at the podium and get the souvenir ticket wallet. Oh, I guess you don't even have to have a boarding pass to get to the counter. Well, I guess if haven't checked in. I don't know who wouldn't have checked in by now, but let's go take care of that.
Clearly, this 747 has a huge, huge fan base, because all of you, immediately when you saw that you had an opportunity to get on board, you did it. And no matter how you did it, whether you used points, whether you used a story, whatever it was, whether you're a revenue customer, whatever it is, you wanted to be here today, and I can feel that connection right here. The 747 is all about connection, right? It connected the world. It connected all of us to, you know, across oceans, across continents, and that is why we're here today. So I just want to take a moment to say, if you're here with someone that you're traveling with, that you're connecting with, that's really the story right now. So take a moment to like turn to that person or find that person later and make sure that you share your own 747 story with them today, because that's what it's all about today at United at Gate 86 and soon to Honolulu is about connection. So thank you. Give yourselves a round of applause for that. And it's emotional. It's very emotional. There's generations of stories here. I saw Mike and Frank. I don't know if you're here or if I can find you in the Chicago gate. They were coming. They were like welling up and talking to me about how excited they were on to get these tickets. I met Jill, who's been a flight attendant for 28 years. She said she feels like she got the golden ticket, the Willy Wonka ticket. I just met Nathan, who's a banker who calls himself an ABE. Thank you, Nathan. Your excitement made me so happy and excited to be here. So this is very personal, and it's hard to say goodbye. I think this quote really said it all. I read it in Hemisphere magazine on my way here from pilot John Russell. He said, imagine the greatest athlete in a given sport retires, and you'll never see anyone like that again. That's how this feels. Do you feel that way? Yes, I'm feeling that way. So obviously the 747 changed, was a game changer for aviation, and this is why we're all here to send her off. So how cool is it that United is recreating the very first flight that flew the 747 from SFO. I'm so like AV tech right now, from SFO to HNL, and so today we get to recreate that moment as well. So how lucky are we that we're all here for that? This is the premier. This is one of the premier routes that the 747 flew to Honolulu, but it flew to Asia and it flew to Europe. And that is the coolest thing about this airplane, because not only is this airplane beautiful, but it allowed open up air travel and allowed people to really get out and see the world and have this global connection. So as we're here today, enjoying this moment, I know so many of you already done so already, but can you imagine how many passengers 42 years later that have raced the jetway up to the 747? It's pretty cool. So take a chance to take your pictures. Please, we ask that you use the hashtag UA747Farewell so that we can get that hashtag trending and get everybody watching all the excitement that we're having here today. Post on Instagram, on Twitter, tag United, and use that hashtag UA747Farewell. I really encourage you guys to continue this connection. Tell your stories. I've heard so many already. Someone already told me that he's only told me the short story, so on the plane I get to hear the long story. So I'm very excited about that. I know, how many of you have slept? Nobody, right? Who needs sleep when you've got the 747 farewell party here today? The flight is going to be so exciting. We can't wait to board. We're going to be boarding at 10:19. But before that, I'm going to come back and give you an introduction to some very special people who are here today that you're all going to want to hear from. So this crowd is pretty awesome. It's deep. It's big. It's excited. And I'm thrilled to be your emcee. I'm Sally Lou Loveman. I'll be on the plane. I'll be back in a little bit. Stop me and tell me your stories. We'd love to hear more. Thank you so much, everybody. Go get some cake, because, of course, the retirement party can't be without cake. So have some cake. The calories don't count today. Hey, we're just going to Honolulu, right? You know, no big deal. We're just going to Honolulu. And most of you are going for the night and turning around, because that's the cool thing to do, right? That is the cool thing to do. You don't go to Honolulu for a week. You go for a night. All right, everybody. Thank you so much. Welcome to the 747 Farewell.
Look at that vintage United backpack. Oh, here are some of the 747 amenity tins that are being given out on international United Polaris First Class and United Polaris Business Class flights this month, and I think through the rest of the year. I got three of those tins on my 747 Global Farewell Tour last week to London, Beijing, and Seoul, South Korea. I wonder how many people like me will have been on the last international flight and the final domestic flight. Yeah. Here's the 747 timeline. And I think these are like replicas of the upper deck first class lounge from the original 747-100s. Hey Mike, do you like this purple flower retro shirt?
Thank you guys.
No, I think it was
So I just here's our retro flight crew.
Yeah, unfortunately I'm just another part.
Here's the 747 timeline, starting in April 1966, when Boeing announced it would build the 747. Made its first flight in on February 9th, 1969. First test flight, first passenger flight with Pan Am from New York to London, January 21st, 1970. Continental Airlines had its first Boeing 747 flight June 26, 1970, the same day, incidentally, that United received its first 747-100. And then less than a month after Continental, United made its first Boeing 747 commercial flight from, guess where? San Francisco to Honolulu. That's right, Mike. Purple is definitely my favorite color. But I've got on United Blue today. So 47 years the 747 has been in service for United. Here's the original livery. And then the final livery here with the post-Continental merger globe. Some retro photos of first class. There's the famous United Tulip logo, which reigned for decades until the 2010 merger with Continental. There's someone sitting on a horse, or riding like a carousel horse inside a 747 engine. I'm guessing that's the christening of the first United 747, splashing champagne onto the side. So where were we in the timeline? Kind of jump ahead to 1985. United announces its plan to acquire Pan Am's Pacific routes, as well as 11 of the Boeing 747SP planes that feature a 48-foot shorter body and fly higher, faster, and farther than the original 747-100. And then September 18th, 1989, which was only 2 months and 2 days before Mom started working for United, the airline launched its first Boeing 747-400 with a trip from LA to Sydney, Australia. 1990, 747-200s were delivered to the Air Force to serve as Air Force One. And after 27 years of service, the Air Force has ordered some of the current model, the 747-8 from Boeing, to serve as the new Air Force Ones.
Boeing delivered the 1,500 747 in 2014, the first wide-body plane in history to reach 1,500 production units. And then the sad day of January 11th, 2017, when United announces it will retire the 747-400 fleet in the fourth quarter of 2017. And then last week, I think that date is wrong. It was October 29th, actually. Whoops, typo. I was on the final international flight from Seoul to San Francisco. And now today, United is celebrating the retirement of the Boeing 747 with a fitting full circle moment. A special retro event sees the aircraft flying from San Francisco to Honolulu, a nod to its first ever flight back in 1970. This is the 6-minute special United 747 retirement video that I posted on my Facebook page a couple weeks ago, and you can find that somewhere on united.com. Just watch that for a minute or two here. Wow, look at those colors. Here's the official 747 cake. And I want to get in line to get my picture with the crew here, so we will return.